Hi, and welcome to QlickFix. This video will demonstrate how to reload a recently converted QlickView document in QlickSense. When converting a QlickView document to a QlickSense app using the QlickView Converter tool, the load script connection string remains unchanged. The connection string format is specific to QlickView load script, which allows for absolute and relative paths as well as for connection string parameters to be stated directly in the script. So when attempting to reload the app with the original connection string, the error seen here will be displayed. In QlickSense, legacy QlickView mode can be enabled by disabling standard mode under the engine's configuration in QMC. However, this is not a recommended practice due to security considerations. Also, legacy mode is not supported in QlickSense SaaS editions. In QlickSense, connection string information is stored in the QlickSense repository Postgres database. These connections are then listed in the QMC under Data Connections. In this example, we see that the QlickView ODBC connector package SQL driver is used to connect to the SQL database. However, this issue is observed regardless of the source database type and even if Windows ODBC data source names are used. In order to correct the issue, a new data connection record that contains this connection string information needs to be created and used instead. The QlickSense installation includes by default the QVODBC connector package drivers, so the Microsoft SQL connector can be selected and configured. In another scenario where an ODBC DSN is used instead, the first step would be to create an ODBC system DSN using the Windows ODBC Data Source Administrator. This on all QlickSense server nodes used for reloading the data. Then select this new DSN when creating the new ODBC data connection. Next, simply click on the Insert Connection String button for the data connection created. Make sure to remove or comment out the old connection string. You can alternatively reselect the data that is needed by the app and then insert the load script. The reload of the app should now succeed and future reloads may be scheduled via tasks. If the app is uploaded to QlickSense SaaS, a new connection will need to be created as well accordingly. Note that in SaaS, the data connections are stored within spaces. If the application is moved to another space and the user scheduling or running app reloads does not have access to the original space, then recreating the data connection in the new space would be necessary. Under the Space Data Sources, click on Add Connection and configure the connection. Thanks for watching.